Good morning, dear children. Welcome back to our English online class. Today, we are going to begin with the Three Sacks of Rice, chapter number 10. You may have read many stories about three brothers. Usually, two of them, the elder ones, are strong, clever, but unkind. They laugh at the youngest one, because he is too simple and soft-hearted. Our story also has three brothers who lived in a small town, but they were all three of them honest, kind, and hard-working. The elder one ran a shop. The middle one was a priest. And the youngest one had just finished his education. He had started taking up odd jobs to earn some money and to learn a trade. All three of them were fond of their mother. She had worked hard to bring up the three of them after the sudden death of their father. Trade means a job requiring skill. One day, their father's friend visited the mother. He said, "Sister, you know that I have a very prosperous business, but now I am getting old, and my only daughter is of a marriageable age. I am looking for a son-in-law who would be a good husband to my daughter and who would also handle my business well. I like all your sons. If you permit, I'll marry my daughter to one of them, but before that I have a plan." He discussed the plan with her and she agreed quite readily. The next day, the friend went to each of the three brothers one by one. He gave them each a sack of rice and said, "My dear boy, I am going away for a few months for some necessary work. Please look after this sack of rice till I come back." The word prosperous means successful. The friend went away. Many months passed, but he did not return. It was nearly a year before he came back. He visited the eldest brother first. The eldest brother welcomed him and gave him a small purse full of money. "Uncle, you had left a sack of rice with me. After a few months, I was worried that it may get spoiled. Therefore, I sold the rice to my customers. Here is the money I got. Please accept it." "Thank you, my boy. You are such an honest person." What do you think of the eldest brother? Was he honest? Yes, he was honest. Because honestly, he returned whatever money he got by selling the rice. He did not keep anything with him. Then the friend went to see the middle brother, who was a priest. The priest greeted him with joy and affection. He said, "Uncle, remember you had left a sack of rice with me a year ago? I had kept it for many months, but then I was worried that it may get spoiled. I distributed the rice among the poor in your name. They all blessed you for satisfying their hunger. However, I did that without your permission, and I am willing to pay you back for the rice. No, my boy, you acted wisely and kindly. The blessings that I got from the poor people are enough for me. Please don't even think about the money anymore. So what do you think about this brother? Did he work wisely? Yes. He gave the rice to poor people, those who were hungry. He also did a very wise and kind job, and he did not waste anything. And he told the businessman that he will give the money also of that rice. So this brother was also a good person. When the friend went to visit the youngest son, he too welcomed him with love and respect. But he said that he had a confession to make. The sack of rice was lying with me for a long time. But then I had an idea. I often go to a neighboring farm to help with the work. I borrowed an unused plot of land from the farmer. I exchanged the sack of rice for paddy and sowed the paddy in the plot. Fortunately, the crop grew well and yielded 25 sacks of rice. I have kept back 5 of the sacks and sold 20 of them. Here's the money. If you allow, I would like to keep a part of it as my share, considering the labor and money I spent to get it all done. A wide smile spread on the friend's face. He had found his future son-in-law. The word confession means a statement indicating that one is guilty of something wrong. Borrowed means take and use something to someone else with the intention of returning it. Paddy means rice before threshing. Labor means work, especially physical work. So children, which brother the businessman chose to become his son-in-law? Yes, the youngest one. Because he used one sack of rice very wisely. That one sack of rice, he changed it into 25 sacks of rice. He had worked hard for it and was ready to pay the money also. So what do we learn from the story, children? That we should be honest, kind, and hardworking. Let us move on to the exercise. In your classwork notebook, start on a new page. Write the lesson's name. Write question number 1 as give meanings of the following words. Write this in your classwork. Then question 2, answer the following questions. This is there in your textbook. Question 1, what common qualities did the three brothers have? All the three brothers were honest, kind, and hardworking. They were all fond of their mother. What was the businessman looking for? And why? The businessman was looking for a son-in-law who would be a good husband to his daughter and who would also handle his business well. His daughter was of marriageable age and he was getting old, so he was looking for a son-in-law. Number 3. How did the middle brother use the rice? The middle brother distributed the rice among the poor. Question 4. Was it right for the youngest brother to ask for a share in the money? Why? Yes, the youngest brother was right to ask for a share in the money because he had done a lot of work and had earned a profit from the original sack of rice. Question 3. This is there in your textbook as question 1. Find the opposites of the following words from the lesson. So this you can do it on your own. Do it in the classwork. Question 1, 2 and 3. Do it in the classwork. Language study. You can also see pages 84 to 88 for more reference. Read the highlighted words. All three of them were honest, kind and hardworking. The highlighted words are honest, kind, hardworking. You are such an honest person. Honest is the highlighted word. The highlighted words are adjectives. Now, find at least 5 other adjectives from the lesson. This also you can do it on your own and do it in the textbook itself. Next question is, list as many words as you can that will go with the given adjective. At least 3 each. Example is given, sudden is the word. Answer is sudden change, sudden shower, sudden fall. So sudden is the adjective and we have to write one more word which is suitable for it. Below few more words are given. Simple. So one example I have given to you that which word you can join to it. Simple machine. So simple word is adjective and machine is added to it. Odd number. Only son. Honest friend. Long dress. So like this you can add 2 more words for each of the adjective given. Children, I hope you have followed the lesson. Once again I am repeating that which questions you have to do it in your classwork. Give meanings. Answer the following and list as many words as you can. This you have to do it in your classwork. Thank you, children, and have a nice day.